Hello everybody, and a very warm welcome to LMT YouTube channel.
Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's second child may make British royal history. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are entering a whole new phase of life and bringing their fans along for the ride. The happy couple took to the internet on Valentine's Day to share the news that they are expecting their second baby. A spokesperson for the couple shared on February 14th, "We can confirm that Archie is going to be a big brother. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are overjoyed to be expecting their second child." Although the couple hasn't revealed their due date or any other details about the pregnancy, fans are excited for them and taking to social media to speculate about all the ways that this second baby will make headlines. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's exciting pregnancy announcement. Fans were shocked when Prince Harry and Meghan Markle revealed on Valentine's Day that they are expecting a new baby due later in 2021. The news was especially joyous for those royal watchers who have followed Meghan's fertility journey, including the July 2020 revelation that she had suffered a miscarriage. The pregnancy announcement included a touching photograph of the pair, featuring Prince Harry cradling Meghan's head in his lap as she gently touches her budding baby bump. Over the next few months, it is very possible that Prince Harry and Meghan Markle will decide to share even more about their pregnancy. In the meantime, fans are looking to what they know about Archie Harrison's upbringing and the one drastic difference that will separate Archie from his new sibling. Archie Harrison was born in the United Kingdom. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle got married in May 2017 in a ceremony that was watched by millions all around the world. Immediately after the wedding, many fans speculated that it would only be a matter of time before they announced a pregnancy. After all, both Prince Harry and Markle had been vocal about their love of children. In October 2017, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle made the long-awaited announcement, revealing that they would soon be adding to their family. In May 2018, Archie Harrison was born at a London hospital. From the beginning, the royal couple made a point of keeping their son away from the spotlight as much as possible, releasing few photos and even fewer details about him. Still, royal watchers all around the world noted that Archie Harrison is still a vital part of the royal family's lineage, even though his parents moved to California before he was 2 years old. Will Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's second baby be born in California? Since moving to the United States, in early 2020, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have been under the radar, working on behalf of various causes that interest them and speaking out on occasion. Still, the two have managed to make headlines fairly often, especially once Meghan released the miscarriage news over the summer. There's no telling what the couple might decide to do next, but it seems likely that they will continue to live a quiet life in their California-based home as they await the arrival of their new bundle of joy. Interestingly enough, while the new baby and Archie Harrison might share many similarities, including the same parents and lineage, they will likely have different birthplaces. Considering all signs point to the fact that Meghan will give birth to her second baby in her home state of California, whereas Archie Harrison was born in London. This is a first in the royal family, and even though Meghan and Prince Harry are no longer senior members of the royal circle, it is still a noteworthy addition to the story of the boundary-breaking pair.
Another analysis.
Why Meghan Markle is no longer eligible for UK citizenship. Meghan Markle's rise from American commoner to royal bride should have been like something out of the Princess Diaries. Instead, the 2.5 years since her marriage to Prince Harry have been marked by nasty gossip, family rifts on both sides, and the famous Megxit break from their official role as royals, which was met with equal parts approval and disdain. While the Sussexes seem to be at peace with their decision to pursue an independent life with their charity work, their production deal with Netflix, and their son Archie, Meghan is still taking heat for what's perceived to be her role in fracturing the harmony at the palace. As now to love details, many factors have worked against her, such as her reported argument with the Queen over a tiara she wanted to wear for her wedding, her frustration at being restricted from social media, and her prickly relationship with the royal staff. It didn't help that Harry and his brother, Prince William, were also rumored to be at odds over Harry's choice of bride. Now, just a year after the Megxit announcement, has it really been a year already? It seems Meghan has opted to maintain her distance from her in-laws' life and lifestyle in a very significant way. Meghan Markle is content to stay an American citizen. The Duchess of Sussex has abandoned her plans to pursue citizenship in the UK. According to the British government's official website, anyone seeking citizenship as the spouse or partner of a British citizen must, among other requirements, have lived in the UK for the last 3 years. But Harry and Meghan moved out of the country in March, shortly after COVID-19 became a widespread pandemic. They stayed briefly in Vancouver and Los Angeles before finally settling on their dream home in Santa Barbara, where they're reportedly charmed by the serene scenery. Prince Harry has no intention of pursuing American citizenship. Meghan's California dream may yet have a happy ending. Sussex fans are taking heart at news that the couple may be on the road to reconciliation with their British clan. The princes are slowly making peace with each other and may even be meeting up in person at some point this year. It's also rumored that Harry and Meghan might be coming to the Queen's annual Trooping the Colour ceremony in June. Even so, there may be reason to hope that the royal family will be united one day, even if one member isn't a full British citizen.
And so on to other news and
how Meghan Markle's personal life shaped her suit's character. Before she became Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, the actor turned royal star on Suits. A legal drama on the USA Network, Meghan left the TV show behind before her 2018 royal wedding to Prince Harry, Duke of Sussex. But while she was on the program, the now 39-year-old infused her character with elements of her own personal life. Meghan Markle spent 7 years on Suits. Meghan is an original Suits cast member. On the show from the beginning, she made her first appearance in the 2011 pilot episode as Rachel Zane. Initially known as a paralegal with a reputation for being the best at a top New York City law firm, Meghan's character went on to become a lawyer. Not only that, but she became the love interest of lawyer Mike Ross, Patrick J. Adams, one of the firm's newest hires. Meghan starred in more than 100 episodes of Suits, leaving the program after 7 seasons. Fittingly, Rachel and Mike were headed down the aisle in the Suits season 7 finale. It marked Meghan's final appearance on the series. The episode aired less than a month before her and Harry's royal wedding, on May 19, 2018. Rachel Zane's jewelry actually belonged to Meghan Markle. Meghan didn't rely on the Suits costume department for every item in Rachel's wardrobe. In June 2013, she wore her own jewelry. Meghan said, "All the jewelry that I wear on the show is my own personal jewelry and family heirlooms, like my grandma's charm bracelet and my signet ring." Meghan often wore dainty gold jewelry or a wristwatch. As the Duchess of Sussex, Meghan continues to wear similar pieces of jewelry, except now she's got her engagement ring and wedding band plus access to jewelry that once belonged to her late mother-in-law, Princess Diana. Meghan Markle's interest in food became part of her character. The Duchess of Sussex is a self-proclaimed foodie and so is Rachel. Meghan told LMT Channel that particular interest of Rachel's came directly from her. She said, "I love to cook. My character is a foodie because they know that I'm a foodie. I'm always on the quest to find amazing new restaurants and new recipes." Before marrying Harry, Meghan ran her own lifestyle blog, The Tig, which included her interviewing chefs, sharing recipes, and offering up restaurant guides. Even though she shut down the site when she joined the royal family, Meghan's love of all things food remains strong. As part of her first royal patronage, Meghan launched a charity cookbook to benefit survivors of the 2017 Grenfell Tower fire.
Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more LMT videos about your favorite stuff. For coming soon, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one. Stop.